Hi, I'm David Robertson. I'm from Scotland.
All right, coach. So first of all, this is your fourth season. So this 4 years, how have you seen the club grow from second division to the Hero I League?
Yeah, I think I arrived in, I think it was January 2017, and the club had only just been formed by about 6 months. There was no infrastructure, there was no kits, there was virtually no equipment, nothing. I sort of took a shot in the dark, and somehow in our first year, or sort of second season really, we managed to win the I-League 2, which was an amazing achievement. I don't think anybody expected this, that of us. And then the story just continued after that. But it was very, very difficult to start. I'd never been to India before, let alone Kashmir. So I found it difficult to start. But as time goes on, it's basically become a second home to me. And, you know, I love every minute of being part of the club. And the club is, you know, getting more and more professional every season. There's obviously hurdles and challenges that come with that as well. But it's made me a better person. And I'd like to think that, you know, myself and a lot of other people that have been behind it from the start have really sort of pushed the club forward, and it's become a bit of a famous club, not only in India but throughout the world. So it's just great to be part of something special that the club is.
If we go back to the point 4 years back when you first heard about this club called Real Kashmir, mm-hmm. and maybe first time you got the offer, what made you think that, okay, this can be a good place?
I think I'd been in professional football for quite a long time, playing and coaching, and was coaching youths in the USA. I was there for about 10 years, and I also coached in the USL with Phoenix, now called Phoenix Rising. But I felt when I got the offer to come, it's a brand new club, brand new experience. You know, normally when you get jobs as a head coach, you're normally taking on someone else's issues, or, you know, maybe the club's at a peak where the manager's moved on to bigger and better things. And this gave me a little bit of a stamp, to put my own stamp on something. And, you know, obviously I never in my wildest dreams expected the club to go so well and so fast as it did. Everybody was on board with it. But it was just a chance for me to, you know, start something from scratch and then see how far it went. And as I say, it's been a bit of a fairy tale really.
Speaking of the fairy tale, if you could give us an insight into the first season, first two seasons at Real Kashmir, when there were so many crowds coming in to watch your games, and, you know, there was so much fanfare around Real Kashmir. If you can give us some insight.
Yeah, I think, you know, when we were in League 2, for example, we were a very young club. Obviously, Lone Star Kashmir were more famous than we were. But even then, you know, people would come to games. It was all men that came to games. And, you know, maybe getting 200 people at a game. And it's more just a case of getting out of the house, watching a bit of football. And then, you know, when we got into the I-League, our first game was against Churchill Brothers. And I think a lot of people, because Churchill Brothers are a very famous club, a historic club, that a lot of people from Kashmir went to watch, you know, because Churchill Brothers were playing. And then it just snowballed from that. You know, I think the atmosphere is great. It just brings everyone together. You know, now at games, you know, one game, I think we've got over 20,000. I don't know how they managed to get all those people in. But we also, you know, there was men, there was women, there was school kids, there was grandchildren, grandparents, all types of, you know, civilians coming. And I just thought it was amazing how it brought everyone together. And they're so passionate. You know, I've been in many places, like in the USA, for example, and the crowds are very... So, it's like put on, it's pretend, but in Kashmir it's passion, you know. And I would hate to have been a team coming to play in Kashmir with the weather and also the crowd, but they're so fanatic, and I just feel for them that this season, and there's been a few games as well where it's not able for them to come and watch us, but we all know that they're behind us, and, you know, teams coming to Kashmir find it very, very difficult, but it's a sheer passion. They're very much like a European atmosphere. It's intimidating at times because the crowd are very close onto us, but they cheer us from the first minute to the last minute. And again, but that puts a little bit of pressure on the team as well. I think we felt that a little bit last season.
What does that tell you about the power of football to bring people together, even in times of adversity?
No, as I say, I think, you know, when I first went to Kashmir, there's not a lot there. You know, not a lot of things you can do in the evenings and what have you. But I just think it's given a lot of the young kids as well, you know, every state, almost every state in India and every city and every place throughout the world, there's a professional team that play that kids you want to aspire to play for and want to play for a hometown team. And it's only since we got in the I-League that that's become possible. And, you know, we've got a good youth setup, you know, start at young ages. And we want to have, eventually we want to have, whether I'm here or not, we want to have, you know, a lot of Kashmir players, young youth players getting into the team. You know, you look at the likes of Naroka and Trau, and a lot of the players come from that area. So that's the long-term plan, but we have to get everything right. But it just gives the people of Kashmir hope. You know, guys like Danish, who's, you know, become a very famous individual on and off the field. And I think if it wasn't for Real Kashmir, that wouldn't be the case. So we hope that, you know, over the years, we produce a lot more Danishes.
Coming to your love story with Real Kashmir, tell us about what makes you keep coming back from Scotland to this small place
in
Kashmir.
Yeah, I think because I'm probably the only coach that the club's ever had. And I look back to the time in the I-League 2 where, you know, obviously the financial part of it wasn't quite there at the time. And it just was the case that it's what we had to do. And I think it's what's made the club very, very special. You know, I've had one or two opportunities I could have moved on elsewhere, but I just feel I owe it to the people of Kashmir. I also owe it to Sandeep and, you know, the people that are associated with the club. You know, I'm not doing it as a stepping stone. I'm not doing it, you know, for financial gains. I'm here because I want to do it. I want to make an impact. And as I say, it's a second home. My wife's been over a few times. Obviously, my son plays here. My other two kids, I've got another daughter and a son, they've both been here as well. And it's amazing that every time I go home, I look forward to the time I come back to, obviously, to Kashmir and obviously in India as a whole. It's just been a fantastic experience, and it's something that I'm glad that I did. You know, I raised a few eyebrows at home when I decided to come here at the start. But, you know, everybody's proud of what's been achieved. And as I say, it's probably the perfect job.
Speaking about raised eyebrows at home, tell us about, you know, how people back home reacted at first.
Yeah, it was very, I mean, obviously my wife in particular, she was, you know, we had a comfortable lifestyle in the USA, and I decided January 2017, I think it was New Year's Eve, that I jumped on a plane, much to her disgust. She wasn't very happy about it. You know, and obviously family were a little bit shocked and maybe a bit concerned about, you know, my safety and what have you. But, you know, I think looking back, everybody now realises that the reason I do it is for passion for football, the winning, the losing, you know, and I think it's now become an emotional attachment, that Real Kashmir is part of my life and part of my family life. You know, and even in the UK and Scotland, Real Kashmir is a very famous club. I'm actually doing an autobiography. It's coming out in March. A lot of it's to do with my time in India. But it's just been a fantastic journey, and there's been a lot of hurdles. There's been a lot of you know, things to overcome. I think the hard part is being away from home. But it's a little bit easier now with Mason being here. But you know, it's you know, everyone now is my family. You know, my wife, my kids, my mother and father. My mother passed away in the summertime there. You know, they're just very, very proud of what's been achieved. And as I say, at some point it'll come to an end, like all football coaching jobs come to an end. But as long as I'm here, I'm going to enjoy it. You know, my family look forward to coming out. But no, it's been a wonderful experience. I think it's made me a more humble person. I think I really appreciate what I've got at home. You know, I was maybe a little bit materialistic when I was, you know, when I was living in the USA, living in Scotland, and you come here and you become a more humble person. And I think it's, when I look at some of the players that we've had, you know, maybe their backgrounds are not the best, and I look to see how well they've done. You know, we've had players that have moved on to, you know, bigger and better things. And I think it's all down to the club. And for me, it's from what I believe, it's one of the best run clubs in India, which is it's a great achievement when you consider where we were 4 years ago, when we We didn't even have a training kit or in dressing rooms or nothing. So we've come a long, long way in a short time, but I know Sandeep wants to make sure we keep going. We don't want to be stagnated in where we are. We want to keep moving on and, you know, going to bigger and better things.
Speaking about your home away from home, being away from your family for so long, obviously you brought Mason over. Yeah. Mason on the pitch has been one of the crucial players for your team over the years. But off the pitch, as a father-son, as a coach as well, coach-player, how has him being here helped you?
I think it first, before I came, up until we got in the I-League, I think the maximum time I was away from home was 4 months. And then it became, you go in the I-League, it's now 8-9 months. And I would have found it very difficult if Mason wasn't here. Even though it goes days apart from training that I don't see him. He's playing Xbox with, you know, some of the players, Chester, Paul or Sam, and, you know, he's doing all the other things, and he really does mix with the players. So I think it's just knowing that he's here, particularly when it comes to Christmas time, knowing that he's here. But, you know, he finds it difficult. His fiancée is in Phoenix in Arizona, miles and miles away. He hasn't seen her for a long time because of the pandemic. Obviously, my wife is... she actually had surgery the other day, so it's hard being away for things like that. But you know, as long as we've got internet, the world's a small place now, so we get by. But just knowing that Mason is, you know, on the same corridor as me, and you know, he'll pop in now and again, I'll go and see him. But he's very much a team player and part of it. But again, it's just knowing that he's there.
And finally, it's been these are difficult times, rather. For football fans all over the world, they can't go to the stadiums, especially when you see the magical atmosphere in Kashmir and now empty stands. It's difficult to take as a coach and a player as well, I'm guessing.
Yeah.
So, yeah, what would you have to say to the fans in difficult
times? Well, I think the fans, it's a bit like the players. The players hadn't played a game for, what, 7, 8, 9 months, and they were so eager to get on the field, even training. You could see their faces light up. And you can see a lot of enthusiasm, not just our team, but every team within the league, even just around the hotel. You can see everyone's happy to be back in as normal an environment as you can. But you can imagine the supporters, you know, they're eager to get back just to watch the games. You know, you can watch it on television or, you know, on social media, but it's just not quite the same as being there. And, you know, I know I can speak for our fans that, you know, we all do a team talk. We always talk about our fans that will be watching back home in Kashmir, that we have to put on a show for them, even though they're not there in person. We still represent them. We're their club. You know, we're not our club. It's the people of Kashmir. It's their club, and we have to do the best for them. But I think it's very disappointing throughout the world that fans can't come to watch the games. You know, I think it's hard. But I think, like the players, once things open up again, hopefully in the not too distant future, they'll appreciate it even more, because I know the players, you know, it's funny, I spoke to one or two of them, they actually appreciate playing football more now than they ever have. They took it for granted, and I think it'll be the same for supporters, that they'll probably appreciate it a little bit more. You know, you can tell at times some supporters get a little bit anxious and critical towards their players if they're not performing, which is understandable, but I think those things will change. I think the whole world will come together a bit more. Okay,
thank you.
Okay, good man, thank you.